And thanks for joining me for another review. Today we have the Alcatel OneTouch Alora. It's a Go phone prepaid by AT&T. It has a 5.5 inch HD IPS display, 16 gigabytes of internal memory. It is running Android Lollipop 5.1.1. It has a front facing camera of 2 megapixels and a rear facing camera of 8 megapixels. This does have 4G LTE, and it is available now through AT&T or Walmart. Let's take a look at the phone and see what the specs and some of the features are. Okay, along the bottom you don't have any physical buttons, but once you press them, then you have the on-screen buttons that come up, and where you can close all your apps and, or go back. If you hold it down, the Google Assistant comes up. Okay, Google, what's the current temperature?
It's 52 degrees in Connolly Springs right now.
And then once you hit that, it goes back to the home screen. This is a very nice phone. It has a 1280 by 720p IPS display. It's very fast, very snappy. It comes with a lot of bloatware, but if you root it, which is very easy to do, you can delete all those and take them off. Just be careful when you're deleting them that you don't delete a system's critical application, because your phone will start acting up. I did that accidentally and had to reset the phone, but that takes care of it once you do it. But you have to reroot it after that. Let's go into the settings. You have your Wi-Fi options, Bluetooth, pretty much the standard for this version of Android 5.1.1. You have your gestures, sound notification, display, lock screen. You can turn your locations on and off, backup and reset. All this information down through here is normally contained under the About phone, except for the date and time. But if you click on the About phone, you'll notice that there's nowhere in this area to update it. But if you go back, AT&T adds a software update above it. I guess it's their way of controlling it a little bit more. But you can click on that and it'll check for an update. They're supposed to be having an update to 6.0, but unfortunately there's very little information on the internet right now that tells you about that. It's such a new phone that I guess no one's really, you know, looked into it yet. Okay, let's go back. And like I said, this is a 1280 by 720p screen. It's very nice. It's bright. It's able to see it in outside in high light, and low light conditions it's even better. It comes with all the Google apps pre-installed. A few of them I deleted, so there's a lot more. But I find that the Maps and the Play Store and the Drive, YouTube and Photos, that's my main ones that I go to. I use the Google Photos as a backup for all my photos. That way I don't have to purchase any of the online services. It has its own recording feature. And it also has the Google Play, which will source either the online backup that you have, or it'll also source the songs that are on your micro SD card. This says it'll hold up to a 32 gigabyte micro SD card, but I put 128 and it worked just fine. So I think that's probably just 32 gigabytes a safe limit for them. There's not a lot to tell about this phone. I more or less wanted to review it because I was so impressed with it. This was purchased at Walmart for $89, and that is a huge deal because it's a 5.5 inch screen and it is 720p. You don't miss the 1080p at all when you're using this phone. It's so clear and bright that you would think this is a flagship phone when you're using it, because it's so, you know, so snappy and speedy. And all your information is right at your fingertips. The only thing that I really have a problem with is when the phone is off, when you turn it back on, that's the only way you can do it. You can't tap the screen. You can't push a button down here. You have to hit this button to turn the phone back on. But once it comes on, you can't just put in your password. You have to slide up. You have to slide up and then put it in. Now, it's very responsive and everything like that, but it just seems like that I should be able to just hit the button and it come up, or just tap on the phone or pick it up and, you know, that it responds to you. The OK Google works on any screen, as you see. Humidity. Okay. It was sort of, I guess it was dictating, but it works on any screen. It works also if the phone is off and it's plugged in, it'll also work, but not if it's, if it's not plugged in, it will not work. So that's a big help if you have it laying on your nightstand at night and you need to know something. But it's very responsive. It's also too, if you set it up on this phone, you can, when you push the button, it will recognize your voice. If you say, "Okay, Google," then it'll automatically go ahead and unlock the phone and it'll go straight into the home screen. So you can go ahead and start using it without having to put in your code or anything. But it also works on that screen. Like I said, this is a very nice phone. I was very impressed with it. I don't usually do reviews of the lower end phones anymore because they're just so generic that there's, unless one really catches your eye. Like I said, the only thing I had a problem with was this opening the screen to have to put in your code, and also too, it's a fingerprint magnet. I mean, it is the worst fingerprint magnet I have ever seen in my life. I mean, it just grabs all the oil off your fingers, and it's hard to clean too. So I would definitely suggest, if you get this phone, to get you a plastic cover to go over it with a also a case. Even though I've not used a case on this and it stayed really nice for over a couple weeks, the camera's looks really nice. It's not cheap. It's got a really nice LED flash on the back. Unfortunately, you do have the AT&T logos and stuff like that on here. I wish they didn't put that on the phones. Down at the very bottom, you'll notice the little place where you take the battery or the back off. So let's go ahead and take that off. Once you get that off, I don't know why they didn't just go ahead and make it in the side. Since you can't remove the battery and replace it, I don't see the point in having the back come off. You have a place for the micro SD card, and you also have a place for a nano SIM. This does take the nano SIM, so be mindful of that when you purchase this. You may have to go to the AT&T store and get you a new one, or, you know, have it cut down if you have one of those tools. This phone will work on the AT&T. It'll also work on Straight Talk. And what most people don't know is it'll also work with Consumer Cellular. So if you don't want to purchase their phones, because some of them are pretty high, and you want a smartphone, this will work with Consumer Cellular. So just know that. For some reason, I guess they use AT&T as the backbone of their system. I've charged it up and it used it for 2 days and a half, and it was down to like 15% after 2 days and a half. So it really holds a good charge, and it charges very fast too. You can plug it in like 30 minutes, you'll have like 60% battery. But the back just snaps right back on. You have your volume rocker up and down. They're tiny, but you can definitely, you won't get it mixed up with the, it's a very nice phone. I would recommend, if you don't have much pocket cash and you're looking for a really good phone that you can be proud of, then this is your phone. I mean, I'm serious. This is the phone that you should definitely get if you're on a prepaid service and you want something really nice. It has all the features of a high-end phone without the high-end price. Again, that's my review of the Alcatel One Touch Allure. If you have any questions, go ahead and put them in the comments below. If there's anything that you'd like me to review, please put it in the comments below. I've opened up a Patreon page. Please check that out. If you're able to help me out, that'd be great. The more money I get, the better products I'll be able to review. And this is my review of the GoPhone through AT&T Alcatel OneTouch Allura. So please check it out. Please check out my other videos. And please subscribe and thumbs up. And as always, I appreciate every single one of you. Thank you.